Hello. I know I look crazy right now, but I'm doing this heatless curl, so just ignore it a little bit. But this week, I am filming a week in my life vlog, and it's Sunday night. I just got back from a Super Bowl party, and I'm about to do my weekly calendar. This is really the only calendar slash planning that I do is I have this pad that's from All Things Lilianne, and I just write the things that I'm gonna get done or that are on the agenda for each day of the week, both work and personal. So I look at the calendars that are on my phone, compile them onto this one list, and then we go from there. Okay, this is the week of Monday, February 12th through Sunday, February 18th. Valentine's Day is on Wednesday, which I'm very excited about. I have a lot of fun things kind of on the books this week for Valentine's Day and then just other things. So I think this is gonna be a fun vlog, but nothing crazy. I just feel like I haven't vlogged in a while. I've been filming reading vlogs and other things, so this was just a fun. Hey, Kate. Way to continue chatting with you, even though I'm not filming a reading vlog. Although I will talk about what I'm reading. But let's see. Kate. Thursday is my mom's birthday, which is fun. It's a pretty light work week for me this week, which is great. I have Pilates on Wednesday, which will be good. And then I'm having a Palentine's with work people on Wednesday also. Thursday, like I said, is my mom's birthday, but my sister and I are also going to see Dancing with the Stars. Which is so fun. And then this weekend, my bestie from college, who's getting married, she's having a shower that I'm going to, so I'll go to her, drive down to Birmingham for her shower this weekend. This weekend I have shower. And honestly, so as I said, it's a pretty light week, especially front-loaded light, which is exciting, but I'm sure things always kind of come up, but this just keeps me in on my mind, like, on Friday, I want to upload my House of Flame and Shadow reading blog. So I have it this on here, but then I'll look at, like, Tuesday where I have nothing, and I'm like, okay, so that I'm gonna do some really heavy editing of Flame and Shadow so that it can be ready for uploading on Friday. So I will put that in Tuesday because there's nothing, no other events on that day. So that's kind of how I plan out my week, is looking when, especially content-wise, I want to upload things, and then backtracking from there. But also on Tuesday, because I usually work from home on Tuesdays and there's nothing else on the agenda, I'm going to put filming some TikTok content and short form content on there, because that's a good day to do it. And I'm behind on some, like, I've read several good books recently that I haven't, like, talked about anywhere. So I need to, like, film some content, get some pictures so I can, like, post it on my Bookstagram and on my TikTok, which are always linked down below if you're curious, because I am not filming that many reading vlogs this month. So a lot of the books that I read, I won't have a reading vlog for. So that means you gotta go see content about it on other platforms. But with that being said, it is 11:20 on Sunday and I do have work tomorrow. So I'm going to get in bed. I don't think I'm gonna read anything. I'm kind of in between books right now. I'm not, like, I don't have anything that I'm really reading. So I'm just gonna go to bed and then I'll see you in the morning. Maybe if I remember to film before I go to work. I always forget, but I'll try. Okay, good morning. I am getting the final touches, putting my earrings in, because I'm going to work. I did that heatless curl, it turned out good. I'm wearing pink sweater, black pants, and then these shoes, white shoes from Naturalizer. This is from Free People. My pants are from Lululemon. And I gotta go if I wanna get Starbucks before work, so bye. And I just got an Amazon package that I believe has some books in it. These are books that I ordered on Amazon, obviously, but I ordered them after I read them on Kindle because I liked the series and I wanted to have the physical copy. So they were Kindle Unlimited, and I decided to buy the physical copies, and that is the Edens books. So not all of them are in this box because they didn't all ship at once. So I have Indigo Ridge, which is the first one. Juniper Hill is the second one. And then Garnet Flats. And then we're missing a few. And then the final one is Sable Peak. This is interesting. Because, so you can see these three were traditionally published, but this one has a different thing on here. And this is like the indie version. And I don't know if you can see this, but I can feel the, you can feel the difference between an indie published cover and like a traditionally published cover. The indie one has that like matte finish, whereas the traditional ones are like satin or like smooth. You can see the reflection. This has no reflection. So I wonder why or that happened. You can also see on the back, like it just looks different, but at least the covers all match. These two do have this like thing on it that says, as you see that, it says as seen on TikTok, which is kind of weird, but, and they also have these, the first two both have like pull quotes on the front, which means they were traditionally published, but it does say these include bonus material, so that's kind of fun. So I have, I think there's two more that I'm missing in between Garnet Flats and Sable Peak. There's six siblings and each sibling has their own book, so waiting on two of those. And then there's also other things in this box, but I don't remember what else I ordered. Oh, this is razors. Amazing, because I needed new razors, and I also got a new hairbrush because my hairbrush was and is like just needed to be replaced. This is Lange wide vented brush in pink. It's a hairbrush, but that's what I went with. So that's my little Amazon haul. I am about to start dinner. It's 6:30. I'm just gonna make pasta. I have like a homemade sauce that I made last week. It's not very good, but I do have a lot of it, so I need to eat it. And I'm gonna do that because I do not wanna be wasteful. So I'm gonna make my dinner, and then my sister had like a work or a thing tonight, so she won't be here. So I have the apartment to myself with Kate, and I'm just probably gonna read, maybe watch a show or something. I just finished a book. I'm kind of midway through two books right now. I'm like 40% through Ashes of the Serpent and Wings of Night. What is it called? Ashes, the Ashes and the Star-Cursed King. That was wrong. But it's the second of the Crowns of Nyxia series. The first one was what was the first one? The Serpent and the Wings of Night, which I read last year, and they're both on Kindle Unlimited, and I was just like, oh, maybe I'll, like, the first one was okay. I think I gave it 3 stars. And so I was like, I'll just read the second one because it's only a duology and I want to finish the series. So I started that. I'm like 40% through. Again, I'm probably in that same 3-star range with it as of this point, but that's fine. And I'm also reading a book for book club, which I do not like. So I'm going to try and get a little bit further in that, but I might end up DNFing it. And then I'm really on this Omegaverse kick, and I just saw a TikTok about this like Omegaverse shifter series, and it's on Kindle Unlimited, so I might get into that just because I don't love either of the books that I'm reading, and I read because I enjoy it, not because I want to like read high art. Like, not that Ashes and the Star-Cursed King is, but Eileen is supposedly a good book, but just not for me. And I am on a Megaverse kick. I'm sorry if I want to read about shifters and nodding and faded mates, okay? I like that. So, I'm gonna make dinner and then I'll catch up with you after that. It's snowing. Can you see that? There it is. How exciting. This is the second time we've had snow this year already. I doubt this will stick because it's supposed to be warm tomorrow, but for now it's really pretty to look out the window and see it. Good morning. Happy Tuesday. I'm working from home today, so I am wearing my Baz Gaeth t-shirt. Hi. As I mentioned maybe at the beginning of this video, whenever I was doing my like weekly planning, Tuesday is a day where I have like nothing on my schedule. I'm doing a little like, we're making pizzas tonight with my sister and friend because it's Galentine's Day today, so we're doing a little celebration tonight, but until then I'm working from home and I have no plans. I do need to go to the grocery store to get stuff for Galentine's Day today, and then I am planning on filming some short form content today because when I was looking at like what I want to be posting, I'm a little bit behind on filming that stuff and getting it ready to go out. So that needs to get done today. I need to go to the grocery store and I need to start editing my HoFast reading vlog because I want that to go up on Friday, because I feel like now people are starting to have finished the book. It's gonna be a full spoilers vlog, and I didn't want to upload it like right away because I felt like I read it in a few days, but people weren't like, didn't read it as quickly as me, weren't finished with it yet, so I didn't want to post my full spoiler review until then. But I have finished it and I'm ready to edit and post that video, so that's also gonna happen today. Those are kind of, I think, the only things on my agenda, those three, and also working. But it's gonna be a pretty chill day. And we got a little snow last night, which was so cute, but obviously none of it stuck. It's only like 40, 50 degrees outside right now, so it really warmed up. But it was pretty well, it lasted last night. I'll show you my little work from home setup, and then I'm going to make myself a little breakfast and we'll get going with the day. Okay, you've probably seen like this angle before, like, cause I sometimes set my camera on the table and film myself like with this in the back, but this is where I'm usually sitting. This chair is the like viral TikTok crisscross chair. I love it. It's comfortable to sit at for long periods of time while I'm working, but I also sometimes just sit here to read because I like the chair and it's comfortable. And the two chairs that normally go right here just sit on this wall, and this is what Emma and I call our like mud room, where we like store stuff. It's kind of a mess. It's not the best. Like, this whole part of our apartment is just like whatever. But love this chair, and then I have this little laptop riser. I've got my laptop, it's always plugged in, and then I've got my mouse and my planner, so this is kind of my thing. And then that way whenever I have Zooms, like, this painting is in the background and it looks good. So that's kind of my work from home setup. So this is both Emma and I's desk and where we eat, but it's nice to have at least, like, before I didn't have a desk at all, and I would just work like either sitting on the couch or like in my bedroom. And so this was definitely necessary to like make this space usable for a desk, because this apartment is so small, we just needed space for it. So that's that. And it gets really good light in here. Like I always, it feels open and airy. So that's kind of that. I'm gonna, like I said, go make breakfast and then get to work for the day.
I was just watching TikTok and I just got a TikTok that's literally just made me realize how amazing Throne of Glass is. Like, I read it last year for the first time and I reread ACOTAR and Crescent City in preparation for Crescent City 3 coming out. I was editing that vlog earlier and I love Sarah J. Maas even. I like ACOTAR, I like Crescent City. This last one was a little bit disappointing to me, but I still, like, in general, like it. But nothing is as good as Throne of Glass. Like, the characters, the heartbreak, like, the way I bawled finishing that book. The Kingdom of Ash. Like, it is just, nothing compares. And I just saw a TikTok. Listen to the sound. It's Aelin saying take it off when she gets rescued and she has the mask on her face. I can't. Anyway, I'm about to make a little treat. Like I said, my sister and a friend were doing like a little Galentine's thing tonight. I went to the store on my lunch break because I have like an hour-ish long lunch. So I went to the store and got a few things for tonight and to make a little treat for my sister. It should be pretty easy. Like the recipe that I saw on TikTok looks like it won't be out. I mean, I bake quite a bit, but it looks like a pretty easy recipe. So hopefully it won't take me that long and I'll be able to get that done. She's at work right now. She won't be back until like 6. So I have a few hours, but I'm gonna go ahead and get that done.
Did we do this last year or no?
We made cake last year.
Oh yeah, I actually remember that. I think I had some.
Hello. It's Valentine's Day. I have a work Zoom, so I'm not fully ready because my first two meetings today are on Zoom, so I'm wearing pajama pants still, but I do have the top part of my Valentine's Day outfit on, except for my makeup, but I got my heart headband, this like sweater jacket, and then I'm gonna wear pink leather pants with it. It's gonna be great. But Emma and I left each other a little Valentine's Day gifts out this morning, so she put this little card that says, oh, happy Valentine's Day, and it's got a little corgi on it. And then this book. She also left the book receipt, or the gift receipt, but this looks great and I haven't read it, so I'm gonna keep it. Happy Valentine's Day, Kate. Happy Valentine's Day. And I left her a little, like, basket thing with some chocolate and some snacks and a candle and a little drink. So that was fun and cute and just great. Love. Emma knows that Valentine's Day is my favorite holiday. As you can tell, so she always has a little gift and I always give her a little something. So it was fun to see that this morning. And this book looks so good. So honestly, I'm really excited. Oh, and there's also a bookmark in here in my spicy book era. So true. So I have that meeting in like 10 minutes. So I'm gonna make myself a coffee and then go do my work. But I'll show you like the finished outfit whenever that happens.
Okay. First of all, I put on pink eyeshadow. I don't know if it looks good, but that's what we did. And here's the full Valentine's Day outfit.
Pink leather pants. My shoes have like pink on the heel.
And that's the completed Valentine's Day look. I'm about to head out to work, but as I said, Valentine's is my favorite holiday. So we are dressed to the nines, but I'll see you later.
Good morning, everyone. I did not vlog enough yesterday. That's on me. But it's now the 15th, and Emma and I are going to see Dancing with the Stars tonight. I'm so excited, but I'm going to work. Kate is you. It's a little chilly, and I'm not sure if I'm gonna, I guess I'll put on a jacket because otherwise I'm gonna be too cold. So this is the starting place, and then I'm literally just gonna put on my whatever this is, jacket. I read Start and Finish a book yesterday because Emma got it for me for Valentine's Day. It was called Canadian Boyfriend. I'll talk about it later, I guess, but it was so cute and good, so I would highly recommend that one. I was just kind of, I wouldn't say in a reading slump, but I've just been kind of like less motivated to like start something new because I've been, I don't know, I just haven't, nothing has caught my attention, and that did. So took advantage of that, read it yesterday, but I also went to Pilates yesterday evening and I had like a Palentine's thing with work friends, which was actually a really good time. But now I'm off. I mean, this is pretty much how my life goes. Work during the day and then I do something in the evening. So let's go.
Okay,
we're here.
Emma and I are going to Dancing with the Stars. We're walking up now. We're kind of twinning, like unintentionally.
Look at all these people going.
Emma and I are shocked by the amount of people that are going to Dancing with the Stars.
It wasn't even sold out.
It was kind of hard to get tickets though.
I saw tickets online today for $50.
Oh, well.
But they were like in the nosebleeds.
Okay, here we are.
And they were single tickets.
Why am I?
We made it.
Our seats are pretty good.
Yeah. The monkey crawled up on stage.
One less lonely girl who? Myself a little coffee and get Kate up here because she needs her drips. There she goes. But as I said, I'm about to make myself a coffee before work. I just work a half day today, which is great. I'm having a few friends over tonight just for like a little girls movie night. And I'm also getting my brows done today, so that's exciting. But yeah. Make coffee. I didn't vlog after we got back from Dancing with the Stars last night, but such a good show. If you have the opportunity to go while they're still on tour, I think they have like a good portion of the tour left, you should go because it was so good and funny and like I just love Dancing with the Stars. I don't know if that's like cringe or chuggy to admit, like is it, I don't know, but I love it and I had fun, so I'm about to do this work, get on with my day. Lunch with my brother because he also lives in Birmingham right now, so it's gonna be a good day. I'm just going down there for the like rest of the day. I'll probably get there before lunch and then I'll be there the rest of the day and then I'll spend the night and then I'll come back tomorrow on Sunday. So it's gonna be a good day. I vlogged a little bit yesterday. I don't really think I did show too much after I talked in the morning, but I did get my eyebrows done and then I had some girlfriends over, which I did get a few clips of, so
It was a good night. It was fun to have the girls over. We ended up watching Now You See Me 2 instead of a rom-com, which I thought we were going to watch a rom-com, but then we kind of shifted and decided we wanted to watch Now You See Me 2, which was fun and funny, and we love magicians. So, as I said, I'm in the car. I'm listening to Taylor Swift. Currently, Exile is ready to be pushed play on. But yeah, I ended up blowing out my hair yesterday after I talked to you, because I am, first things first, lazy in the mornings. So if there's any way to make my morning routine better or more streamlined, I'm gonna do it. So I did blow out my hair yesterday and then sleep with my overnight blowout contraption in, and I just think it looks so good, really. I did add a few curls yesterday. Like, after I blew it out, I used my curling iron and added a few curls, so. But I didn't, like, hairspray them or anything, and then I just put it in the overnight blowout, and it's cute. It is much colder today than I anticipated it being. I thought for sure it would be, like, in the 40s, but currently it's 28, which is a significant difference to me between 40, 45, and 28. So I'm wearing a dress. I'm wearing a maxi dress, so it's long, but it's short sleeved. I mean, it's a dress. So we'll see. I did bring a jacket, and we're just gonna hope I don't get too cold. It's at like a brewery, so it's inside, but sometimes breweries, they have like all the doors open at all times, and I'm like, okay, but what about those of us who get cold or those of us who get hot? So anyway, we'll see. I'm excited to see Catherine, and they just, her and her fiance just bought a house and have been like fixing it up, and I've been getting all the updates, so I'm excited to see the house and see what they've been doing to it, because although I've driven by it, they didn't have the keys yet last time I was there. So now they have the keys, and they've like repainted, they've changed the light fixtures, all that jazz. So I'm excited. It's gonna be a good day. Yeah, I will see you when I see you.
Starbucks, what can we get for you?
Hi, can I get a grande iced chai with oat milk?
Grande iced chai with oat milk, anything else?
And then can I get the bacon gouda breakfast sandwich, but with no bacon?
Bacon gouda with no bacon, yeah.
And
anything else?
That's all.
Okay, 1 second, let me make sure we have one of those sandwiches.
Okay.
Okay, we got it.
Okay.
It's 12:51. We'll see you up here.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Let me get my...
How are you doing today?
Good. 1 second.
Thank you. Thank you.
I was quick. Like, there was no one in front of me in line, and I just zoomed to the... Okay, now I've got to put this in my phone. Because... this is my first time coming to the Starbucks, and when I pulled up, I was like, oh shit, is this going to be in a grocery store? You know how sometimes you accidentally route yourself to a Starbucks that is not, it's like in a Target or it's in a Kroger or, you know, and I'm like, that's not what I wanted. Or it's like on a college campus. I'm sorry. I've just wasted my time. Okay. Now we're on the way to Birmingham. Starbucks first. Then friends. I have a 11:15 arrival, which is perfect. It'll be there before lunch. And the shower's at 4, so I have plenty of time.